Hello everyone, welcome you all in our YouTube channel Engineering Shiksha. In this particular channel, we are going to discuss some engineering subject. So we will start with our first subject, that is circuit network. Okay, circuit and network theory. These subjects are very helpful for all the students of UG and as well as diploma students who are right now studying in the branch of electrical EC and IC branch. The first question rises here is that why we are teaching this particular subject in this YouTube channel. The reason is that during this pandemic situation, we have found that there are many colleges are right now closed and the teaching are actually stops. So what we thought that we will try to cover this online classes and try to help the students, those who cannot attend their offline classes. The second reason is that we are receiving the feedback from our colleges also where we are teaching online. The problem is that students are finding out the difficulties of their limitation of data pack. The reason is that they are having around 1.5 to 2 GB data pack only, and when they are attending 2 or 3 lectures, then data pack will be over. So they cannot attend more lectures and they are asking for us an offline solution or maybe possible some social platform when we record that lectures and student can be download later on whenever they are having available Wi-Fi networks or maybe possible they are having data pack on some other days. For example, Sunday they are having their data pack and they can utilize their data pack. So by receiving their feedback, we thought that why not only for our student, let us try to record the video lectures for all the students, those who want to learn this subject, that is circuit and network. We have found that there are many lectures are available on this YouTube platform, okay, but most of that lectures are actually covered GATE syllabus, and the GATE syllabus and university syllabus are not actually the same. Right or wrong, you cannot have a question like draw the circle diagram in your GATE examination, but in your exam or university exam and in your college syllabus, definitely you have to draw the circle diagram. For network class, you have to derive the expression for your RC circuit voltage across the capacitor. But in GATE classes, they will not ask such derivation. They will not ask to solve or provide the steps to solve your Thevenin theorems in your GATE class. But in your university class, definitely you have to provide some kind of theory explanation also. So with this keep in mind, I thought that let us design and develop some course that will be helpful for the students for their university exam. So with this background, let me start my first concept, and that is known as transient analysis. So let me first discuss what I am going to cover in this transient analysis. So in this transient analysis subject, initially I will start with my first topic, that is known as initial condition. The second concept that I am going to cover, that is known as transient in RL and RC circuit. Then next part that I am going to cover, that is known as transient in R, L and C circuit. So these are the topic that I am going to cover in my first 8 to 10 online lectures. So first I will cover initial condition. So in this particular chapters, okay, I will require around 3 lectures. So in this particular chapter, I'm going to discuss the transient condition or initial condition for RL and RC or maybe possible RLC network. So in this particular case, we are going to solve the current which are flowing through circuit, that is known as I, or maybe possible we will solve di by dt, okay, that is known as a change in the current, okay, rate of change of current with respect to time, that is di by dt. We will solve d square I by dt square. So this kind of concept or this kind of solution we will provide in our first chapter, that is known as initial condition. Then we will discuss our next chapter, that is known as transient in RL and RC circuit. So in this transient in RL and RC circuit, this is also known as your first order differential equation. So this first order differential equation, we will solve the various parameters like the voltage across the capacitor, current which are flowing through inductor, or any other node voltage, potential at any other node, that we are going to solve in this particular case. This will also require 2 to 3 lectures to cover this particular topic. Then after that, we will discuss transient in RLC circuits. So whenever you are having a series combination of RLC circuit or parallel combination of RLC circuit, you are actually encounter a second order differential equation. So how to solve this type of example, that we are going to discuss in our next 3 lectures. So totally the plan for next 10 lectures that I am going to discuss with you right now. So with this background, let us start our first topic, that is known as initial condition. So I hope you will enjoy this lecture series, and definitely you can find out this is helpful for your NSEM examination. So with this, thank you all. Once again, welcome you all. Let us discuss about very initial stage. What do you mean by transient analysis and what do you mean by steady state analysis? So when I am saying that response of the any systems are changes continuously, then that response or that state of that particular circuit are known as transient analysis. And when I am saying that the response of the steady response of your systems are not changes continuously, or you can say that they are actually attain some steady state value or some steady state state, then that state is known as steady state analysis. For example, let me plot the voltage across the capacitor if I am going to charge. So let us say this is the charging behavior of capacitor voltage, and after some time this will attain some constant value. So this region, when I am observing the voltage across capacitor, this axis voltage across capacitor and this axis. So when I am observing the voltage across capacitor, so during this instant, during this time instant, it is continuously changing. So the response of my systems are continuously changing, and that's why these states are known as transient state. When I am observing this state of voltage across the capacitor, then it is having some constant value, and because of that, this response of the voltage across capacitor are known as steady state response. So remember, whenever we are having LC circuits or whenever the presence of L or C circuit in the combinations of your network, electrical network, then your response are mainly divided into part. The first part is known as a transient analysis, and second part is known as steady state analysis. So we will try to cover this behavior of the R and L and C circuit, and we will solve this circuit and network for various example. We will solve through various example. So now let us discuss about the first 3 elements that are very important whenever you start to learn initial condition. So in circuit network subject, you mainly deals with 3 elements, that is known as R, L and C. So right now we are trying to understand the behavior of three subjects with respect to your transient analysis. So let us first cover the element that is known as resistor. So if I am having, let us say, a resistor which are having the value, let us say R ohm, and some current I is flowing through this circuit, then you can say that the voltage between these 2 terminals, V, that is equal to IR. This element is our favorite element as far as our analysis part is concerned, transient analysis part is concerned. The reason is that this will not change its behavior with your time changes or with respect to your times. So it means that even some times are collapsed, or you can say that at t equal to our initial condition, what is the voltage drop across the resistance, then it should be equal to IR. Sir, after time, whether it is going to be change its property, like it is shifting from open circuit or it is short circuit, no. This will behave as a resistor, whether it is t equal to 0 or it is t equal to infinite. And that's why you can say that this is your independent, or this is timely independent element as far as your analysis of transient part is concerned. Second thing is that voltage and current through these resistors are changed very instantaneously. It means that if I am suddenly change the voltage, then the response of this circuit could be a very sudden. It means not that the current which are flowing through this resistor will take some time and after that it will respond. No, this could not be happened. And that's why we always know that this will respond very quickly. So remember that whenever voltage and current through this resistor, you change or made sudden changes, then it will respond very quickly. So this is all about the resistor. Now let us discuss about the second and very important, that is inductor. To understand the behavior of inductor, let us consider some circuit, that is V. You are having some resistor and let us say some inductor L. I am considering one switch, so let me write down here. You are having one switch and you are just closing this switch. Okay, so you are having one switch and right now you are closing this switch. So if I am going to measure the current, that is IL, then IL in this particular circuit can be written as V by R 1 minus e raised to minus R by L into V. Okay, so this is the expression that are flowing through, or current which are flowing through inductor, that is the voltage that you are going to apply. Let us say you are having some value of resistor, this inductor is having some value of L. And if I am going to measure, or if I am going to calculate the current, current IL, that is equal to V by R 1 minus e raised to minus R by L into V. Remember this expression, you may study in your BWE class also, and may be possible when we are studying the Laplace transform, then also we will derive this equation. But right now we are assuming that you all must aware with this equation, that IL, that is the current which are flowing through this inductor, that is equal to V by R, where V is the applied voltage, R is the resistance, then it is 1 minus e raised to minus R by L into tau. This is also R by L, or you can say that also known as your time constant, that is L by R. Okay, so you can also represent this L by R ratio with your time constant, that is known as tau by tau, that is equal to L by R. So let us say if I will put t equal to 0 in this expression, let us mention some name, let us say expression A. If I will put t equal to 0 in this expression, I will get e raised to 0 is 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0. So what you will get? You will get the current which are flowing through inductor, that is equal to 0. What does this mean? It means that at t equal to 0, current which are flowing through inductor, that is equal to 0. How? It means that if I am saying that the current which are flowing through this circuit equal to 0. So IL, that is equal to 0. What does this mean? Current cannot flow through this circuit. So if I am having open circuit, then and then this possibility could be exist. Yes or no? So it means that if I will draw the circuit like this, let us say I am having a resistor and this inductor is open circuit. It means that in this particular case only, you can say that your IL equal to 0 ampere. If this is present in the circuit or this is the closed path, definitely IL equal to 0 could not be possible. So with this behavior, you can understand that at t equal to 0, your current which are flowing through inductor, that is equal to 0. It means that at time t equal to 0, inductor behave as a open circuit. This is most important parameter to understand the behavior of inductive circuit. Remember, t equal to 0 means actually what? You are closing this circuit, that is instant is known as a t equal to 0 for right now. But remember, the main thing is that this is the instant when your inductor come in influence with this battery first time, and this will start charging. So this is before the switching, this was uncharged. So this uncharged inductor, when coming in contact with this energy, it will start charging. And during that instant, when it will start charging, at that instant, this inductor behaves as a open circuit. Is this point is clear to all of you? Now let us proceed. We are using the same expression that IL, that is equal to V by R, 1 minus e raised to minus R by L. In this expression, I will put T equal to infinite. If I will put T equal to infinite, what I will get? This is e raised to minus infinite. So what I will get? 1 minus 1 upon e raised to infinite, that is 0. So this term is 0. So I will get IL, that is the current which are flowing through inductor, that is nothing but equal to V by R. So it means that the current which are flowing through this circuit equal to V by R. What do you mean by that? How it is possible? Let me draw. This is your voltage and this is your resistor. And your inductor, if your inductor behave as a short circuit, then and then only it is possible that the current which are flowing through this inductor, that must be equal to, okay, that IL must be equal to by R. Agree with me? So it means that the conclusion is that at time t equal to infinite, your inductor will behave as a short circuit. Or in other words, you can say that when your inductor is fully charged, then that inductor will behave as a short circuit. So if I will plot the curve, then my curve will be look like this. Okay, let me draw this circuit. Okay, let us say this is your time axis and this is my current which are flowing through inductor. This instant, we can say that this is my instant, let us say T equal to 0 instant. And my inductor will start charging, right? And after some time, my inductor is fully charged. So this particular charging, at this charging instant, my inductor current is nothing but equal to, known as, that is equal to V by R. Okay, and during this instant, this is the period, at this period is known as your transient analysis. Okay, and this period is known as your steady state analysis. Okay, this is known as your inductor is attain a steady state, and during the steady state, current flowing through this inductor is nothing but equal to V by R. Now one question is that this instant that I am writing down right now is equal to T equal to infinite. T equal to infinite doesn't mean that you have to charge your inductor for a very long period. No, it is not like that. The thing is that this will depend on your time constant tau. So this is generally that this time is nothing but equal to phi by tau. So this will depend on the value of L and value of R. So generally, if you are having or if you cover the phi time constant, then your final inductor will reach to a steady state value. So remember, this is your initial condition. At initial condition, current which are flowing through inductor, that is equal to zero. And then your inductor is charging, right? And after some time, that is known as how much time? That is equal to phi tau. After that time, your inductor will attain a steady state value. Is this point is clear to all of you? Now, let us discuss about another point. What is the voltage across inductor? Voltage across inductor, that is nothing but equal to L di by dt. Agree with me? So remember, this point, if you observe this curve, this is the point when inductor current is continuously changing. So if I am saying that inductor current is continuously changing, it means that voltage across the inductor is also continuously changing parameter. Okay, and after this point, voltage across inductor is what? L di by dt. And this current is equal to what? Steady state current, constant value. So for constant value, di by dt is 0. Okay, if current is constant, di by dt is 0. I can say that after this time also, VL equal to 0. And we know that in short circuit, voltage that are across these two terminal, okay, that must be equal to 0. So you can also verify this parameter with this circuit only. So I hope this all the points are very clear to all of you. Friend, remember one thing. Let us say I am applying a V voltage. Now suddenly I will apply or I will change. Let us say instead of V volt, I will apply another voltage to it. Then what happened? Remember, let us say at this point, okay, at this point, I'm suddenly apply a 2 volt instead of V volt. Now I'm applying a, let us say, 2 into some V volt, that is 2 times V volt. Then what will happen? You change the circuit parameter. So definitely once again, you come into the which region? Transient region. And again, your inductor will start charging. And after that, you will reach another steady state value, that is 2V by R. So during the transient analysis, your voltage across the inductor is continuously changing, or you can say that your inductors are present in the circuit. During the steady state circuit, you can represent your inductor with a short line. Okay, and whenever you apply another changes, your inductor will start charging again for that next steady state value. The next steady state value equal to how much? That is 2V divided by R. So it will finally steady state at some another value, that is V by R. Another one important point you must have to remember, that whenever you apply any kind of switching, okay, generally we consider the switching at time t equal to 0. Then always remember, current which are flowing through inductor just before the switching and just after the switching, that always remains same. So I should mention here, that is IL 0 minus, that is equal to IL 0 plus. This is the reason. What is the reason? The reason is that inductor always oppose the instantaneous change in the current. Okay. So you can also observe here that inductor current is not changed instantaneously. This is always increased in a gradual manner. So whenever I am considering any kind of switching, let us say this instant. Okay, this is my, let us say, switching. Okay, I will take some time. Let us say 11 a.m. At 11 a.m., I am doing the switching and I am closing this circuit. So, if 0 ampere current was flowing at 11 a.m., I can say that just after the 11 a.m., just after means some microsecond, after 11 a.m., some microsecond will collapse, then at that time also, 0 ampere current will be flowing. And just before the switching also, 0 ampere current is flowing. Let us say this is the instant, okay. Let us say this is the instant. At this instant, let us say 2 ampere current was flowing. Then just after this also, how much current is flowing? That is also equal to 2 ampere. No doubt, if I am considering the gradual, or I am considering the major amount of the time, then maybe possible I can say that this is not true. But just before the switching and just after the switching, current flowing through inductor should always remain same. So let us conclude what we have discussed about the inductor. The first thing is that inductor behaves as an open circuit at time t equal to 0. But remember, this t equal to 0 means what? This is the time when inductor will start charging. Your uncharged inductor was first time start to charge. Okay. When inductor will fully charge, it will behave as an open circuit. Okay, when you apply another changes, then inductor will again start charging, and then again it will come into the contact, or then again it will reach to be another steady state value and it will behave as a open circuit with your new circuit parameter. Voltage across inductor, that is L di by dt. We can also observe that here in transient analysis, your currents are continuously changing. So it means that your voltage are continuously varying, and it means that you can say that your inductor was present in the circuit. After this, when you are reached to a steady state value, that is also referred in our analysis, that is equal to t equal to infinite, your inductor will behave as a short circuit. You can say that current which are flowing through inductor is constant value, and that's why the constant, the differentiation of constant will equal to 0. So you can say that voltage across the inductor is 0. So, voltage across inductor is 0 means what? Inductor will behave as a short circuit. And third, major important point, always remember that current which are flowing through inductor just before the switching and just after the switching will remain same. Inductor always oppose the instantaneous change in current. Okay, so with this, let us move towards our next element, that is known as capacitor. Try to understand the behavior of capacitor similar to your inductor. So let us assume that you are having a RC circuit, and this is your switch. If I am going to measure the voltage across this capacitor Vc, then the expression that is Vc equal to V 1 minus e raised to minus t divided by RC. Just like in our previous case, Vc equal to V 1 minus e raised to minus t by RC. This is your basic equation that you studied in your basic electrical class, and we are accepting this instruction as it is. And definitely, if it's possible in Laplace transform, we will derive this equation. So right now we are assuming that Vc, voltage across capacitor, that is equal to V 1 minus e raised to minus t by RC. Okay, we are accepting this this equation as it is. So now let us try to understand the behavior of your capacitor. So this is your resistor R, this is your capacitor C, and let us say you apply some voltage. In that case, Vc equal to V 1 minus e raised to minus t by RC, where 1 upon RC is also referred as 1 upon RC is referred as also your time constant, that can be also referred in many books, that is equal to tau. So let us take t equal to 0 in this expression, let us mention here, that is equation number B. Let us put t equal to 0 in this equation. If you put t equal to 0 in this equation, that is e raised to 0. So e raised to 0 equal to 1. So voltage across capacitor Vc, that is equal to 0. When you put t equal to 0, e raised to 0, e raised to 0 is 1, 1 minus 1, so that is equal to 0. So voltage across capacitor Vc, that is equal to 0. What does this mean? It means that your capacitor or behavior of capacitor is exactly opposite to your inductor. At time t equal to 0, inductor was behave as a open circuit, while capacitor was behave as a short circuit. Why capacitor behave as a short circuit? Voltage across capacitor is 0. Okay, so if I am having a short circuit, then and then only I will get a 0 voltage. Okay, so it means that at time t equal to 0, it means that if I am closing this circuit and let us say this is R, then my capacitor will behave as a short circuit. Okay, this is my equivalent circuit for the capacitor at time t equal to 0. Now what will happen? Now after this time, your capacitor will gradually start charging. So to try to understand the behavior, let us put t equal to infinite time. I will repeat, this is just for the mathematical expression t equal to infinite time. It doesn't mean that you have to connect your circuit for, let us say, 4 hour, 5 hour. No. It will depend on your time constant, that is 1 upon RC. Generally, it will take 5 time constant to attain a steady state value. Okay, so what will happen? Let us say t equal to infinite. If you put t equal to infinite in this equation, what you will get? You will get e raised to minus infinite. So this is 0. What you will get? Voltage across capacitor is nothing but equal to V. Okay, so it means that the voltage across the capacitor, that is equal to V. So can I say that the current flowing through this circuit equal to 0? Because current is always flowing from higher potential to lower potential. Now the potential of this voltage equal to V, battery voltage, and capacitor is also reached to a voltage that is equal to V. So current cannot be flowing through this circuit. Are you agree with me? If I am saying that, let us say this is having some potential, you are having some resistor and you are having, let us say, capacitor. Okay, this potential has V voltage. This potential is also reached to V voltage. What does mean? Current cannot flow into this circuit. Are you agree with me? The reason is that current is always flowing from higher potential to lower potential. But now potential of these both terminals are same. So current which are flowing through this circuit equal to 0. What do you mean by the current which are flowing through this circuit equal to 0? What do you mean by that? This is nothing but ultimately this must be a open circuit. Okay, so at t equal to infinite, your capacitor will behave as a open circuit. And must remember that inductor behavior and capacitor behavior was exactly opposite. Okay, inductor, when it is fully charged, it will behave as a short circuit. And when capacitor was fully charged, it will behave as a open circuit. Okay, so let me draw the voltage curve with respect to time. Okay, friend. So let us say this is your time axis and this is your voltage across capacitor. Okay, so at time t equal to 0, let us consider this is the time t equal to 0. I will repeat again, this t equal to 0 doesn't mean that you are doing the switching. Remember, t equal to 0 means when your uncharged capacitor will come in contact with your energy first time. That instant is known as t equal to 0. Now capacitor will start charging, and after some time capacitor will attain some value, that is Vc, that is equal to, so at t equal to 0, voltage across capacitor Vc equal to 0 volt. Okay, so at t equal to 0, voltage across capacitor is 0 volt. Then gradually capacitor will start charging, and after some time, that is 5 tau, where tau is nothing but equal to 1 upon RC. During that instant, your capacitor was fully charged and voltage across capacitor is equal to Vc equal to V. Okay, so what is the current which are flowing through capacitor Ic, that is equal to C dv by dt. Remember, friend, inductor always oppose the instantaneous change in current, and capacitor always oppose the instantaneous change in voltage. So I cannot say that the voltage across the capacitor will change suddenly. It is not possible. Okay, so gradually that can be changed. Gradual change can be possible. The sudden change in the capacitor voltage would not be possible. Anyway, let us discuss about this point. This is your voltage across capacitor. So this is dv by dt. Okay, this is the voltage changing continuously. So because of the changing of the voltage continuously, you will get current which are flowing through capacitor Ic is also varying quantity. After some time, whenever your voltage attain a steady state, remember this is your transient part, whenever your capacitor will attain a steady state value, after this instant dv by dt is constant, so Ic equal to 0. So current which are flowing through capacitor is also equal to 0. You can understand this behavior with this equation also. Okay, so the important point with this slide is equal to, at initial condition, at time t equal to 0, your capacitor will behave as a short circuit. Then capacitor will start charging. After some time, that is known as t equal to infinite. Or you can say that after 5 tau, or after 5 tau time constant, your capacitor will attain a steady state value, and that value equal to how much? Capacitor voltage Vc equal to V. Remember, friend, Ic, that is current which are flowing through capacitor, is nothing but equal to C dv by dt. So during this changing interval, your voltage are continuously changing. So it means that current which are flowing through capacitor is also going to be a change continuously. And you can say that during this instant, capacitor was present in the circuit. After this instant, voltage is constant, so current equal to 0. So you can say that now current is continuously 0, so inductor will behave as a open circuit. Next point is, voltage across the capacitor. Capacitor always opposes the instantaneous change in voltage. So I can say that voltage across the capacitor just before the switching, just after the switching, will remain same. Okay, so let us say if I am considering any instant, let us say this is the instant. Okay, this is my interest. So if I am doing switching just before the switching and just after the switching, voltage across capacitor will remain same. Most of the time we will doing our switching at uncharged capacitor at this instant. So if I am doing the, let us say, switching at this instant, then just before the switching if capacitor voltage is 0, then just after the switching also capacitor voltage will remain at 0. Okay, now let us say at this instant, Okay, after some time interval, if I'm applying, let us say, I will change my voltage from V to, let us say, twice of V. Then what will happen? Then you are actually doing the transient part. Okay, you are making some changes. So from that sudden changes, your inductor will respond to that sudden changes and will start to charge again. So again, this will be a transient analysis. And finally, after some time constant, this will reach to a new steady state value, that is twice of that. So remember, there is one confusion in most of the example. Okay, they are doing the switching sometime at this instant, and sometime they are doing their switching at this instant. Okay, and this instant they can consider as t equal to 0. Okay, but remember, this t equal to 0 indicate your switching instant, and switching instant and the behavior of capacitor for t equal to 0 always different. I will repeat this concept whenever we are discussing our example. This t equal to 0 mention that this is the first time when capacitor will come in contact with your battery source. And this t equal to 0 sometime in example will be considered as the instant when you are closing the switch. These two things, it is not necessary that always be equal. And remember, one more point is that after whenever you are doing the any kind of the switching, and when capacitor will present in the circuit from the next interval, at that time your capacitor will behave as a voltage source in series with the capacitor, and same way your inductor will behave as a current source.